is? What's up, guys? I literally just texted you where you're at.
I was getting clips outside.
Oh, for sure. What's up, guys? Welcome back. I know, I think it's been like 2 weeks since the last episode. I think that was that's how long it's been. I'm 5.5 weeks out now. Very exciting. A lot of things has changed. Calories dropped slightly. Cardio has decreased. I went from 40 to 30, so that was pretty fun. Today is the special day because I know everyone's been asking when I'm gonna do a leg day, and it's today. I actually have big news too, which I'll be revealing later on. But right now we're warming up my legs. I always start leg days with a seated bike for 10 minutes. This will help overall help with my warming up on my legs, helps with, you know, my hips, my knees, my ankles. So we prevent any injuries and make sure that my mobility is key. So excited. Here with my boy James. So we're gonna go kill it. We got 2 more minutes. So we're gonna start with leg extensions. We're gonna do a couple sets with that. Then we're gonna do a hack squat, leg press, seated hamstring curls, Bulgarian split squats, and then lunges. So I already have all the workout plan laid out. Now it's time to execute it. In between sets, I like to do lunges, so we're gonna do our first exercise. Is gonna start off with leg extensions. We're gonna do about 6 to 8 sets. We're gonna do 2 warm-ups, 2 3 working, 2 top sets, and a backup set. So we're gonna get started. We're gonna just do 20 reps, just get it all going.
What's your favorite flavor for Zero Gatorade?
This and the yellow one. And it has to be this blue. The light blue, not the dark blue.
I feel like yellow is like every Asian's like favorite.
Honestly, yeah.
My dad just downs them like crazy.
So the reason why we do lunges in between sets, one, it's for mobility. So a lot of times, when people squat or people do any leg movements, their mobility sucks ass. So doing this in between sets helps to get the blood flow into your quads, but also helps with the knee flexion and ankle flexion. So it's really good to do it in between sets when you're doing like leg extensions, hamstring curls, and all that stuff. So it gets everything going.
Get up. Go. Yeah. 3, 4, 5, 6, keep going. 7, 8, come on. 9, come on. Let's go. 1 more.
Excuse me.
7.
Ah!
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 9.
Last
one.
Ah! 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 Better than last time. Way better than last time.
Come on!
Come on!
No! Come on! Just fuck him! Yeah.
Get up!
Ah!
So you train with Sonny since the beginning of his prep.
Yeah.
What are the differences between 18 week out Sonny versus 5 and a half a week out Sonny?
Well, what's interesting was I feel like what I thought would be the biggest difference, which would be training intensity. It's insane. The training intensity, as he gets closer, the intensity gets so much higher. I thought that like as you get closer, you're cutting down on the calories. You're tired all the time. But that's just, sometimes we have full workouts and like we barely say a word to each other. But it's just so like it's so locked in, it's so intense, he's so focused. I mean I'm so focused also there with him. So I'll say that's one that's not like that's a surprise that it's not a difference that you would think it's a difference. I mean the biggest difference is bro is just like cut up, like insane. Like I gotta say, I wish he still had the beard. I think that would have been sick. But like, he is like, the visual difference, especially in person. Like you see it on camera, but in person, it's like it's for real.
How does it feel being his training partner, being like kind of like the backbone that keeps him in check, so he's just like constantly keeping that intensity up?
Yeah, honestly, bro, it's like it's honestly like an honor in a way because like before I really started training with Sonny, I hired Sonny as a coach. I didn't really have nobody really like in the fitness community. Like, I was pretty much on my own, just kind of like doing my own thing. I didn't have any friends in the fitness industry. And when we started lifting together, in a way he kind of took me under his wing. We started training together and that's all I ever trained of because like I needed someone to push me and take me to that next level. So being able to train with him, being able to take it to the next level, being able to watch myself help him get to the next level is like an honor, you know, in itself. Like, he's a really great guy. He's gonna do big things. And just like being a part of the journey is just like, damn, I'm really here, like step by step, side by side with him, so.
And just one more. With the weeks counting down, we're in the single digits.
Yeah.
We're almost at like 2 or 3 weeks left. How excited are you? Like, do you feel like you're about to compete yourself?
You just talk shit about me? You better.
I've never competed, so I don't even know what the intensity would be like, or the like, build up to a show would be. But it's like I'm getting my own visual representation through him, and like I was telling him earlier, like you don't get butterflies before some workouts. Like you know you're not pushing hard enough, you know. So it's like getting ready before this workout. It's like
all I have to say is this is my first time, because I've done 2 shows already, but this is the first time I've actually had like a real training partner. It's night and day. I have to give James a lot of credit, more than I haven't really been giving him much credit for. But I wouldn't have pushed the weight that I've done. I wouldn't have, you know, exceeded a lot of my expectations in this prep if it wasn't for him. There were days where like I wasn't feeling it, and then James pops up and fucking just hypes me up and gets me going. And you know, if you have a chance to have a training partner, including during your prep, you know, it's well worth it. And I think my biggest progression was due to him being around. And I wouldn't be able to, you know, like I said, I wouldn't be able to progress in my own prep if it wasn't for him. Like, there would be days where I was struggling and he would be there. Even if I failed my sets or my lifts, it was just his support and his well-being of him just being near me was like helping me push through all the exercises or all the workouts that I was mentally not there. So, you know, I have a lot of love and a lot of respect for James for, you know, even being around and, you know, accommodating, because he works hella long hours. You know, he works at a stressful job and he still shows up here. And so I appreciate like all of it. So it's fun coaching him, but it's also fun, you know, being his training partner. So I really, really appreciate it. So time for the big reveal. Let's fucking go.
That actually was one of the best leg days. 2 weeks ago was a good one, but this exceeded that one. So it was really great. It was a fun experience. Fucking died. Pretty sure you're gonna feel this tomorrow. Anyway, big reveal. It's already out there. My coach already posted it. Me posing in open bodybuilding trunks. So if you don't know what that is, it means that I am competing in the open bodybuilding division. This is something that I actually have been thinking about ever since my second show last year. Like, when I got off the stage last year, I looked at myself and like, as much as I love classic, everyone has been in my ear saying, I'm not built for classic. Like, that I train, that my mindset, the way that I hold myself is like a bodybuilder. I don't ever consider myself a bodybuilder, you'll never ever hear it. But the way that people have been telling me is that I do bodybuilding, or I'm a bodybuilder at most. So all through 2021, that's all I kept thinking about was, what if I compete in open? What would happen? And then when I got with my new coach, Phil, funny thing was, at 8 weeks out, I messaged him saying, hey Phil, I wanted to talk to you about something. This has been in my mind for over a year. What would happen, or would you approve of me doing open bodybuilding? The funny fucking thing was, he replied back and said, I thought that was a fucking plan. He already thought that I was going to do both classic and open. So I was like, this is awkward, because I literally didn't know. I thought you just wanted me to do classic. He's like, no, look at your fucking plan. It says classic / middleweight open bodybuilding. And I'm like, oh, that's
you gotta read your plan.
I was like, why did you read that? I was like, well, no, I saw it, but I thought it was just because, like, it was like, I thought you just put it there for the fuck of it, you know? So I didn't know. So my own coach had already planned of me doing both. But then when we talked about it, it's now set in stone. So I was hiding it. No one knew. Only person that knew was one friend in San Diego and my girlfriend. Those are the only two people that I told, because I was very nervous. I didn't know what to expect, but I just said, fuck it, let's fucking do it. So I ordered my trunks. I got them 3 days ago, and here we are. So let's go do the big reveal. And this is gonna be a sneak peek at 5.5 weeks out. Usually I always throw like a week out, like an old photo of myself or anything else, but this right here is how I look right now, and I'm in my bodybuilding trunks. So you guys are gonna get a little short clip of me posing, and yeah, let's get it.